So this is by far the easiest and the simplest way to make the skin smooth in Photoshop. No frequency separation, no plugins, no AI tools. And I'm going to show you how to do this on a headshot, medium shot, and a full body shot. Okay, let's do this. So first, let's start with this beautiful headshot image. So I'm going to go on window here. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select actions here. On my action panel, I'm just going to left click on these four lines, and then I'm going to select button mode here. And then from here, I'm going to go to my beauty retouching actions pack, and then I'm going to select auto skin retouch headshot. I'm going to left click on it like this. So I'm going to show you how to load these actions in Photoshop in just a moment. But first, let me show you how they work. So the action is loaded here. The brush is already selected for me. What I'm going to do from here, I'm just going to go on top here. Opacity, I'm going to leave it at 100%. And then flow, I'm going to take it to 20%. Just going to select this and type 20% here, like this. And then from here, I'm just going to paint where I want to make the skin smooth. So I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger using the brackets on the keyboard, like this. And then from here, I'm just going to paint this part to make it smooth, like this. So the goal this year is to reach 100,000 subscribers. So I'm gonna ask for a favor. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please consider subscribing so that we can reach 100,000 subscribers, or 80 or 70,000 subscribers is okay by the end of this year. And if you want to see more videos like this, don't forget to smash that bell icon so that when I put up my next video, you will be notified. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. How cool is this? Let me just zoom out a little bit. Control or Command plus 0 on the keyboard, like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So this is the quickest way to make the skin smooth in Photoshop. No frequency separation and no plugins. This is the before, this is the after. To finish retouching this photo, I'm going to go back to my beauty retouching actions pack here. On the pro retouching actions, I'm going to select the face pop action here. I'm going to left click on it like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. What this action has done, it has just added the highlights and the shadows to this image. If I want more of that, I can just go on top here. On the skin retouching actions, I can just left click on the auto dodge and burn here, like this. The brush is already selected for me. The only thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to go on top here, opacity 100%, flow, I'm going to take it to 100%, and then I'm just going to paint where I want to dodge and burn. So I'm just going to make my brush a little bit bigger using the brackets, and then I'm just going to paint my model's skin to bring back those highlights and shadows. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If the effect is too much, you can always reduce the opacity here to maybe 25%. This is the before, this is the after. So this is the before all the actions, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let me just make the eyes whiter. I'm going to go down here to my retouching actions pack, and then I'm going to select teeth and eye whitening. I'm going to left click on it like this, and then I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. Then I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller, and then I'll just paint the eyes like this. So this is the before, this is the after. Let me just zoom out, Control or Command plus 0 on the keyboard. I'm going to go on opacity here. Then I'm just going to reduce it to maybe 45%. So this is the before all the adjustments. This is the after, this is the before, this is the after. We are done. This is the quickest way you can skin retouch your photos. So if you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my beauty retouching actions pack. The link will be in the description below. So I'm going to move to the medium shot here. I'm going to go up here on my beauty retouching actions pack. I'm going to go to the pro retouching here, and then I'm going to select auto skin retouch medium shot. I'm going to left click on it like this. The brush is already selected for me. Opacity, I'll leave it at 100%. Flow, I'm going to take it to 20% here. Just going to zoom in a little bit, Control or Command plus on the keyboard, like this. I want to make my brush a little bit bigger, and then I'll just paint the skin like this. Okay, so I'm going to move to this part. Then from here, I'm just going to move down here. I'm just going to paint this part like this. Okay, let me just zoom out. Control or Command plus 0 on the keyboard like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. To finish retouching this photo, I can just go on my pro retouching actions here, and then I'm going to left click on the face pop action here like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So from here, I'm just going to color grade this image. So I'm going to go down on this circle, I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select selective color here. Let me just take this guy here so that we can see what's happening. So from here, I'm just going to go on colors. On reds, I'm going to take it to plus 5 like this. On the yellow here, I'm going to take it to plus 5 like this. I'm going to go back to colors here. I'm going to change it from reds to yellows here. On the cyan, I'm going to take it to negative 6. And then I'm going to go back to colors here. I'm going to change it from yellows to blues here. I'm going to take the cyan to plus 5. Magenta, I'm going to take it to maybe negative 10. And then the yellows, I'm going to take it to plus 20 like this. So from here, I'm going to go back on colors again. Then I'm going to go to neutrals here. I'm going to take the cyan to plus 2. Plus 5 is okay. And then I'm going to take the magenta to negative 1, and then I'm going to take the yellows to negative 2 as well. On the black, I'm going to take it to plus 2 is okay. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So the effect is not too much, but it's there. I'm done retouching this image. Let's move on to the full body shot. So I'm going to go to this image. So this is a full body shot. So from here, I'm going to go to my beauty retouching actions pack, and then I'm going to select auto skin retouch full body shot. I'm going to left click on it like this. So the brush is already selected for me. Everything is already set for me. The only thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure opacity is at 100%, flow is at 20%, and then I'm going to zoom in, control or command plus on the keyboard like this. I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger using the brackets on the keyboard. I'll zoom in again just a little bit, and then I'll just paint where I want to make the skin smooth like this. So this is the quickest and the easiest way you can make the skin smooth in Photoshop. So with this method, you don't need to do any frequency separation. You don't need any plugins for this method. Let me just zoom out, control or command plus 0 on the keyboard. So this is the before, this is the after. Let me just zoom in again. This is the before, this is the after. I'm going to go back to my beauty retouching actions pack, and then I'm going to select the face pop action here. So this is the before, this is the after. Let me just zoom out a little bit. Control or command plus 0 on the keyboard like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If the effect is too much, I can just go and reduce the opacity here to maybe 50%. Then I'm going to go back to my beauty retouching actions pack. I'm going to select the contrast here. I'm going to left click on it like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If the effect is too much again, you can just go on the opacity here and reduce the opacity to maybe 40%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So now let me show you how to load these actions in Photoshop. So I'm going to go on these four lines here, and then I'm going to select load actions. So if you can't find your action panel here, or if you can't find your action button here, just go to window here and then select actions. So what I can do from here is just to go on these four lines, left click on it, and then select load actions here. So from here, I'm going to locate the folder where my actions are saved. In this case, the action is saved in my downloads folder. So I'm going to go to my downloads here. I'm going to left click on it, and then the action is here. What I can do from here is just to select the action like this. If I want, I can double click on the action. The action will be loaded in Photoshop, or I can just go on load here. So once I click here, the actions will be loaded in Photoshop. And then from here, you can proceed doing what I was showing you. So if you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my beauty retouching actions pack. The link will be in the description below. And if you want to learn the simplest and the best way to color grade your photos, you should check this video here.